father says reading Walt Whitman is a waste of time, despite the fact we share his last name.
Hello, my name is James, and I am a sad poet.
My therapist, Dr. Bird, has informed me that I should try to be more positive. So like Walt Whitman, I wake up every morning with a song of myself. I say,
I am James Whitman. I am light. I am truth. I am might. I am youth. I leap from my bed to greet the day.
I brush my teeth with enthusiasm.
But no matter how hard I try to be upbeat and optimistic, a dark cloud hovers over my brain.
James!
This morning, breakfast with my parents is a jovial affair.
To start, we have a lavender-infused café au lait.
Our main course is?
Smoked salmon tartine.
Divine. Just divine.
And for dessert, tarte de fruits.
I even recite some Whitman to celebrate the culinary delights. This is the meal pleasantly set. This is the meat and drink for natural hunger. It is for the wicked, just the same as the righteous.
Bravo.
Bravo, James.
Bravo, bravo.
Well done.
But in reality...
Hey, Dad, have you given any thought to what I asked you about?
The answer is no.
But we
there's nothing wrong with you.
There is something wrong with me.
No, there isn't. God damn it.
Hey, don't talk to him like that.
He makes himself sick in the head thinking he's sick in the head.
It's not his fault.
Then whose fault is it?
It's your fault.
Oh, it's my fault.
Well, you're never around. You're always at work.
And you indulge him. It's no wonder he is how he is.
How he is? How he is? What is that?
It means you're a parasite.
What did you just say to me?
Nothing.
How dare you talk to me like that?
How dare I?
How dare you? You son of a bitch!
What did you just call me in my house?
This isn't your house.
Oh, it is my house. I paid for this house. Do you pay for this house? No! I'm not going to let you this
trap. Just leave.
Enough!
Just leave.
Walt Whitman was a nature enthusiast. So when I walked to school, I hugged trees. On a bad morning, I hugged dozens of them. I recognize his behavior as odd. I'm discussing it with Dr. Bird.
Dr. Bird, do you think it's abnormal to hug trees in order to feel better when I'm stressed out?
Well, James, I don't think it's exactly what you'd call normal.
But, like, what is normal, really?
Not that.
I'm weird, I know.
but as King James wrote in his best-selling novel, The Bible, judge not, lest ye be judged. Think about some of the things you do when you're alone. Imagine butterflies drawn in by a flower so bright they forget how to fly. That's the feeling I get from Sara Seltzer when she's dressed in her springtime warm weather wear. I want Sara to notice me, but not the sick in the head brain cloud part of me.
The laws of physics, kinetic versus potential energy.
Whitman wrote, "If anything is sacred, the human body is sacred."
I think he was referring specifically to Sara's left clavicle.
If I were a normal kid, I'd just go up to her and say something like,
"Are you a Middle Eastern dictator? Because there's an uprising in my pants."
Pop quiz!
Is she looking at me? I think she's looking at me. Is she looking at me? Of course, all I want is for her to look at me. But now that she is, my mind and body betray me.
James, hey. James, wait up.
I will not be awkward today.
Hi.
Good, thanks.
So, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. I think my heart might drown in its own blood.
Anyway.
Her touch is like the explosion of 1,000 atomic bombs. I said, you're a cliche. What?
Sara, come on, we're gonna be late. Oh, shoot. I really need to talk to you, but I. Hey, are you going to the Baron's Croquet Club Champagne Social on Friday?
If you listen closely, you'll notice that Sara has a slight lisp, which I find adorable, but which also accounts for the fact that she's more sensitive than most of the girls of equal physical stature. It must have been hard for her growing up.
Hi, my name is Sara Seltzer. My name is Sara Seltzer. My name is Sara Seltzer.
The Baron's Croquet Club Champagne Social? I don't know. Is that something do you think I should go to?
Well, I'll be there.
In my slow motion, instant replay memory of this moment, I will see thousands of strands of her hair lit by sunlight. I will notice freckles that I've never seen before. I will notice that her lips form the platonic ideal of a plum. I want to say something romantic, but all I could think of is how hot her ass looks in that dress.
Sara, come on. I'm late for gym, but come to the party. We need to talk, it's important.
Dr. Bird, I almost had a blitzkrieg today.
I'm sorry to hear that. And how did this almost blitzkrieg express itself?
Oh, the usual.
Rapid perspiration, respiration, and palpitation.
Correct.
James, do you think that maybe you use the term blitzkrieg to make light of and therefore distance yourself from the reality that what you're suffering from is an actual psychological disorder?
Possibly. I don't know. Yes.
And do you know what set off your panic attack this time?
Sara Seltzer.
Oh, I see. Well, as Dr. Freud said, we are never so defenseless against suffering as when we love.
I understand that Dr. Bird's not real, but my father refuses to pay for a psychologist, and pigeons always struck me as good listeners. The Baron's real name is David Griffin. He claims to be a descendant of Hungarian royalty deposed by Kaiser Wilhelm I during World War I. He is obsessed with projecting an aristocratic air and is completely delusional about his station in life. The thought of the Baron's croquet club champagne social makes me sick. Well, not sick, but like my throat is closing and I'm going to choke to death for no reason. Suddenly, my mind becomes overwhelmed by dark thoughts. Ebola. The extinction of the dinosaurs, child soldiers in Africa, the death of Marilyn Monroe, the collapse of the gold standard, total thermonuclear war. But none of this scares me as much as
social gatherings. Dr. Bird, is it normal to dread them?
Of course it is. People are filthy animals.
They are, aren't they?
My advice is to just be...
I'm sorry, did you just coo? Or did you say just be cool?
Cool. I said, just be cool.
Cool. Right.
James, in order to pursue this potential love relationship with Sara Seltzer, you must confront your anxiety disorder head on.
Must I?
Yes, you must.
But...
You know what, Dr. Bird? You're right. The Baron's Croquet Club Champagne Social is my crucible. It's time for me to conquer my fear of social situations, and hence, by so doing, find the true love I seek.
Shit, I overdid the sarcastic return eye roll. Now she probably thinks I'm spasmodic or I have a degenerative ocular disease or...
Sit! I'm not going!
What happened?
I'm allergic to champagne. Croquet's an elitist sport. The Baron's not even really a Baron.
James. I want you to think about this. If you attend this party, what really is the worst thing that could possibly happen to you?
Let's scream.
James, don't you wish you could wake up one day and just celebrate yourself?
I'm trying to. But first, I have to figure out who I am. Know thyself, said Socrates.
But do you think anyone can ever really know themselves?
Probably not.
So, then don't you wish you could just celebrate yourself?
I don't know. Maybe. Okay, fine.
Hey, Derek, do you think we could actually ever know ourselves?
What'd you say, Whistle Dick?
This is my best friend, Derek. He is completely antithetical to me in every way.
Well, if we could never really know ourselves, then how could we possibly know anyone else? And if we could never know anyone else, then it's like we're these lonely little creatures trying to reach out and make connections with all these other lonely little creatures. But there's no point, because if we can never really truly understand ourselves, then by the transitive property, we can't understand anyone else either.
You need to find a lady and kiss her where she pees.
Yeah, that's probably true. You're in a sterile, right?
Man, this Rockus is off the hook.
I know you don't want to love me, but you don't have to be so cruel.
Evening, gentlemen.
What's up, your heinous?
I'm experiencing excessive and unreasonable fear. I'm feeling self-conscious, like I'm being watched, like I'm being judged, like I'm being criticized. I'm afraid I'll be embarrassed in front of everyone.
Hey, what stuck up your prison purse?
I don't... Do you see Sara? I don't see Sara. I'm going home.
What do you mean you're going
home? James!
Sara.
My boyfriend, Martin.
Your boyfriend?
Anyway, I'm so glad you came.
Why?
Well, I don't know if you know this, but I'm the editor for the school lit mag, the Magum, and we're in the state finals competition, and I was wondering if maybe you'd write a poem for us.
If I'd write a poem?
Yeah.
That's why you wanted me to come here tonight to write a poem.
Yeah.
She has a boyfriend. She has a boyfriend.
Well, I mean, everybody knows how talented you are. And
she has a boyfriend.
I just figured since you were gonna come, I could ask.
She has a boyfriend. She has a boyfriend. She has a boyfriend. Shut up. She has a boyfriend. Shut up. She has a boyfriend. Shut up. I'm an idiot. She has a boyfriend.
I'm sorry. Did I say something wrong?
She has a boyfriend. Shut up.
Are you okay? You kind of have this weird look on your face.
She has a boyfriend.
James?
Stop saying that.
James?
Stop saying that. Stop saying that. Stop saying that. Stop.
James! Are you okay?
Just can you excuse me for a second?
Let's pray.
It feels like I'm watching a movie of my life. Like the entire world is just a figment of my imagination. Like I'm completely alone, and nothing outside of me is real. Don't freak out. It's in my head. Please don't go crazy. It's in my head. Don't freak out. Nothing's real. Please don't go crazy. Nothing's real. It's in my head. Don't freak out. Maybe nothing's real. Please don't go crazy. Shut up. It's in my head. Don't freak out. Shut up. Please don't go crazy. Please don't go crazy. Don't go crazy. Please don't go crazy. Don't go crazy. Please don't go crazy. Sara? Sara?
Okay.
No, not really.
Shit, Dangus. You need to sip some suds.
Another one. One more. Is that you? Come here to write poetry.
You didn't?
No, I came here. I thought you came here to what, James?
I note the time and position of the moon.
I came here to.
I look into her eyes.
This.
As our lips touch, all of my worries disappear. And for the first time in my life, I feel at peace with the entire universe. I want to fuck it through her, metaphorically speaking.
I wouldn't say that either.
Walt Whitman would.
You're not Walt fucking Whitman.
Derek is right. I'm not Walt fucking Whitman. I'm James fucking Whitman. And one day my therapist, who, yes, is an imaginary pigeon, asked me,
James, don't you wish you could wake up one day and just celebrate yourself?
And you know what I said? I said, yes. Yes, I do. And then he shat on me, which in some cultures is good luck. So now, like Walt Whitman, I wake up every morning with a song of myself. I say, I am James Whitman. I am light. I am truth. I am might. I am youth. I leap from my bed to greet the day.
I brush my teeth with enthusiasm. And at least until the next Blitzkrieg comes, I will celebrate. I will celebrate myself. I will celebrate James Whitman. In my voice, I will sing of myself. I sing.
Wait a second. Is my eye twitching? My eye is twitching. Why the hell is my eye twitching?
Oh, shit.